Whenever I first pitched the idea to a few people, I had other plans for this video. Then a world went into a pandemic. So I decided to flip the whole video and decided to start the video with what the world has gone through since we've been in high school. And then the memories we've been able to make despite what all has happened in the last 4 years. Thank you, Freedom, for giving us high school memories that we remember for a lifetime.
We are going to make this decision now. The Fox News decision desk has called Pennsylvania for Donald Trump. This means that Donald Trump will be the 45th president of the United States.
Do you condemn any interference by Russia in the American election?
By Russia or anybody else?
You condemn their interference?
Of course I condemn. Of course I can. I don't know.
It was 1 year ago tomorrow, on a Sunday morning like this, when we came into work to early reports of a shooting at a club in Orlando. We didn't know much more. By the end of the morning, we were covering the worst mass shooting in the history of the United States. For our Sunday closer, Gabe Gutierrez returns to Orlando.
The death toll rising from that deadly attack in London. A single attacker using a car as his weapon, mowing down people on a bridge to the British Parliament.
This morning, investigators are questioning the man behind a deadly terror attack in Lower Manhattan. An attack he apparently committed in the name of ISIS.
Good evening. Thank you for joining us. Breaking news out of Manchester, England tonight. A deadly blast outside of an Ariana Grande concert, killing at least 22, injuring at least 59. Police treating this as a terrorist incident. The leading theory, a suicide bomber.
A huge number of sexual assault and harassment survivors are sharing their stories online.
It happened to me too.
Me too.
It happened to me too.
And it happened to me too. This is my story.
Hey, good morning, everyone. Let's get straight to the breaking news. Harvey provoking an unfolding flooding disaster in America's fourth largest city, Houston, Texas.
This is all happening right now as we come on the air, and the situation is unfortunately dire. People trapped in their flooded out homes. They are fleeing to their attics, taking to social media, begging for a rescue.
The eye of Hurricane Maria just came ashore in Puerto Rico. The storm weakened slightly overnight to a strong Category 4, but officials there predict entire towns will have to be rebuilt.
Hurricane Irma is barreling towards the Caribbean with winds reaching 180 miles per hour. The Category 5 storm has prompted hurricane warnings in Puerto Rico and the U.S. Virgin Islands. Florida is under a state of emergency and preparing for dangerous flooding.
Here it is. At least 58 people now dead, more than 500 people wounded in a horrific shooting on the Las Vegas Strip. It's the deadliest mass shooting modern United States history.
Our program with broken hearts in yet another American town, which today became the site of yet another deadly school shooting. A high school in Parkland, Florida became the scene of chaos and panic just before the end of the school day. The Broward County.
We are here in the nation's capital because of the government shutdown. Today was day three, and then Senate Democrats deciding to give in on the Dreamers, with a promise from Senate Republicans that they'll take up the issue soon.
This monster hurricane now closes in. At this hour, Florence is a dangerous Category 3, with winds up to 120 miles an hour.
This is what nearly 48 hours of catastrophe looks like. As Dorian, the most powerful storm to ever hit the Bahamas, crawled its way through the islands, at times coming to a complete standstill, with wind speeds of 180 miles per hour.
Two mass shootings 13 hours apart, and new demands from so many in this country that our leaders do something, that they offer more than words. I have talked with so many families here, and it never gets easier. Their lives have been destroyed forever, and this time, everyone wondering here, when will it end?
Welcome to CBS This Morning. We're talking about one of the great symbols of Paris and all of Western civilization. It is still standing this morning after a fire that nearly destroyed it. Flames brought down the spire and much of the roof at Notre Dame Cathedral yesterday.
Update you on the situation if you're just now joining us. At least 14 dead, 50 injured. A lot of those injuries are severe.
The deadly school shooting south of the border. The shooter just 11 years old, opening fire on his teacher and fellow students with two guns. The teacher was killed, several students wounded, and ABC's Chief Justice.
Good afternoon from New York. We're coming on the air with breaking news, very sad news to tell the sports world. The LA Times is reporting that retired Los Angeles Lakers basketball star Kobe Bryant has been killed in a helicopter crash.
news. More breaking news, this time in Texas, where a manhunt is underway after a deadly shooting inside a bar.
A SARS-like virus, which has infected hundreds in China, has now reached the United States. Airports around the world are stepping up health screenings on passengers arriving from Wuhan, China.
Beach Sports.